Hello, in this video I will demonstrate how you can deploy your FastAPI backend apps on Amazon Web Services as a Lambda function for free. If you're ready, let's dive in. I have already developed a translation API using FastAPI. As you can see, the API has 4 endpoints. Now we will slightly modify this code so that we can deploy it on AWS. First things first, we need to install a Python library called Mangal. This library is an ASGI adapter that handles complex tasks for us. After installing the library, we need to import it and use it in our code. We only add these lines and we are done with that. Okay, the coding part is done, but we need to zip all the code and libraries used so that our app can execute as a Lambda function on AWS. First, we detect all the libraries used in the app and export their names to the requirements.txt file. Then, we will run some commands to zip them all. You can find the commands in the description. Now, it's time to deploy the FastAPI app on AWS as a Lambda function. Log into your AWS account and go to Lambda. After that, click on Create Function button. Enter the necessary information about your API. Make sure that you choose the correct version of Python here. You can find out your Python version simply by running the command you see on the screen on your terminal. Don't change anything else on this screen. Use the default values. Then click on the Create Function button below. Now choose the zip file we have generated before. Our code has been successfully imported. You can also make some adjustments on your Python code here, but don't forget to click on Deploy button on the left-hand side. We're not done yet. We need to edit the runtime settings. Adjust the name of handler here. Since the name of our Python file is main.py and the name of the handler function is handler, we write main.handler here. Then we save it, of course. After that, we test if everything works as expected. We create a test event here. Give the event any name you want. Then choose the template as API Gateway AWS Proxy. Then adjust it like I did. Path refers to the name of your endpoints. Don't forget to change HTTP methods as well. My test failed because I forgot to deploy the changes I've made. Let me deploy it and try again. Okay, the test is successful now. To be able to use this API, we need to create a function URL for this API. Click on Configuration and Function URL on the left-hand side. Then click on the Create Function button. Choose the authentication type as None. Then click on Save. Okay, let's test if it really works online. Let me go to the ping endpoint. Now, let me translate the word hello into French. Yes, we can see the translation here. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video.